A new clinical trial out of South Africa finds that a J&J booster provided strong protection against Omicron, reducing the risk of hospitalization by about 85%.
Yeah, a lot of people, though, have been shying away from Johnson & Johnson of late. Here to answer your questions, Dr. Todd Ellerin, Director of Infectious Diseases at South Shore Health. Dr. Ellerin, good to see you. Thanks for your time.
You too.
All right, so those results certainly sound encouraging, but since most people who originally got J&J, including yours truly, got a different booster, what do we know about that protection?
Well, first of all, here's the good news. The good news is that as long as you're fully vaccinated, and especially if you're boosted, you're going to be very well protected against severe disease. And that's what the two J&J shots showed in South Africa in the Sasanke trial. 85% reduction in hospitalizations in the healthcare workers that got the two doses about 6 to 9 months apart compared to those that hadn't gotten the booster yet. We know that the same is going to be true with the mixing and matching, but we don't have that those clinical trials yet to show us. But we know if you started with J&J and then get the mRNA booster, you're going to be very well protected against both infection and hospitalization.
So it's too soon to say whether those people who got Johnson & Johnson should be on the hunt now for a third shot somewhere.
Well, that's right, because remember, most of the people that got the J&J shot have only gotten their second shot right now. We do know that ultimately, after a certain period of months, maybe 6 months, that they will absolutely need another dose. But most of them are not there yet.
Okay.
Good to see the boosters are working. So yes, Let's get some questions from our viewers. We've gotten quite a few about how COVID can be transmitted these days. The science has evolved so much. So let's start with what we know about how it's spread.
Right. So we know that it's spread mostly through the air, through close contact. So you can see here in the graph, extended close contacts in the household, extended contact if you're in a car with the windows closed, face-to-face in restaurants over extended period of time. The key is really close contact in the air, you know, through those larger droplets or smaller aerosols.
And close contact, is that still kind of 6 feet? You know, that was the old guidance, but do we know with Omicron and with Delta?
Right. So, you know, the science, the aerosol science hasn't caught up yet. And we think that most likely Omicron may be able to hang out and you may be able to get infected with a shorter period of time. But I think the 6 foot rule is still reasonable. I wouldn't say that we have to extend it, but the further away, the better. And then how it's not spread. OK, this is really important. It's not spread on your iPhones. It's not spread through surface contamination of shopping carts or by passing, you know, a serving plate around or by your dog. I've been asked, is it okay to have your dog join you for New Year's Eve? And the answer is absolutely. We're more likely to infect our dogs than our dogs are to infect us. So I think those hopefully
good. And no more wiping down the Cheerios.
Right. All right. Here's a question from one of our viewers. This is from Bill. He says this: suddenly the Celtics and the Patriots are getting COVID. Why haven't they received 1, 2, 3 vaccinations? Are they getting the original COVID-19 or are they getting Omicron? So what say you, Dr. Ellerin? Is this Omicron at work?
So, Ben, we know the reason why, and it's not just the Patriots or the Celtics. It's the NFL, it's the NBA. It's our community. Our community, we're seeing more COVID right now in the United States in the air than we've ever seen before. The wastewater surges are like nothing we've seen. So, meaning we really have COVID air. So, of course, you're going to see more of the, you know, the Celtics or the Patriots become infected. Remember, there's 96 NFL players out just on Monday, just on that one day, the highest in since the beginning, and the same is true for the NBA as well. So I think the key is just knowing the silver lining going into the new year is that most of the cases are mild, but even though many of these players are not only fully vaccinated, but many of them are also boosted, you can still get infected, but it tends to be very mild, and that's good news.
It is,
and they're tested a lot. So you find
That's
it. You find the cases. Dr. Todd Ellerin, thank you so much for being here.
Take care, guys.
All of your knowledge, as always.
Thanks, Dr. T.
Happy New Year.
Happy New Year to you as well.